just going to make another video today about Camber. There's a couple of things which people aren't aware of, what the car actually does on the track, not just what it does on the setup station. I'm going to explain that now and show you the difference when using different camber gains and how that relates to on-track performance. So I've helped lots of people doing this. I've had all sorts of weird issues with the car. Feels a bit floaty. Doesn't get that bite. I love a car with good bite and corner speed. And if it doesn't have that, and the car's usually running the same tires and everything, you can almost guarantee that it's down to the way the car bites into the surface. And that then comes back to camber and a few other things, but camber usually will help a lot. So this is my right rear. This has got a standard instruction book setup on the right rear with standard link heights and the camber gain. It's set to 2 degrees static, and if I just press down, it moves bugger all. So it's pretty standard, pretty linear. Doesn't really move. Okay, so it stays at about just over 2 degrees when I press down. Now normally you'd go, okay, cool. People like to set their camber gains to 0.5 or maybe even 1 degree, so it increases by that much. But why do you need camber gain? Well, it's funny because people never actually check this, but I'm going to twist the car now. Instead of just pushing it to the ground like that, which is useless because a car doesn't corner like that, does it? Corners when it's actually gripped up and turning. So if I twist the car like that, chassis is almost scraping and the inside is kind of lifting up a little bit. We're mimicking what the car would do on the track. We're now at almost 1 degree positive camber. Now, that's bad. That's going to roll on the outside of the tire. That's going to cause all sorts of problems, and that's going to not bite. It's going to cause corner speed issues. That's going to cause tire wear issues. The back's going to come flying around, and it's going to be hard to drive. But people think, oh, it's something else. So I'm going to show you now on the left side. This is a setup that I run all the time. And this is using a shorter inner link, so it's down, angled down further, and higher outside link. What it does, if I press down now, just static, you'll see that it's 2 degrees static. Press it down, goes to almost 3 degrees, and that's cool. But then what we actually do is we twist the car. It's on the track. Yeah, chassis on the ground, insides up, and it's just under 1 to 0.5 negative camber. Now, what that's going to do is mean that the car, when it's in mid-corner, going full speed, the tire's not overloaded. So it's always actually searching for grip. There's always bite there, and you can get the car to roll. You don't want to roll too much, obviously, but this helps the car bite. You don't want too much camber. Just about 0.5 negative camber is about right. Any more and it can be a bit taily. It can also have the same effect as not enough. So you'll find that sweet spot. But definitely negative camber, like what I've got here on the left side, is what you kind of want to look for. You do not want the tire fully loaded and being positive camber. And now we've done the back of the car, turn it around, and same rule applies, except this time you would press down statically like that and you would see, that 1 degree gain. But that's not what happens when the car's obviously in the middle of a turn. It's going to be at full lock or have some steering lock on, right? So you want to turn it full lock and apply the same rule where you twist the car. So we're going to twist it and mimic almost hitting the chassis on this
this side here where it would maybe chassis scraping, who knows, but just get close and try and mimic it, and end up with about 1 degree negative camber on the front there. And I like that. I like my cars to have a lot of front bite. If I go less than that, it can sometimes feel like it's pushy and a bit rubbish, to be honest. So yeah, just next time you check a new camber, make sure you roll the car and mimic what it's going to do when it's at high grip, and or not even high grip, medium grip as well, and it's biting and it's turning, and then check your camber, because that's what it's going to do on the track. Setup station's cool, but you've got to mimic what it does on the track, and then that'll give you a closer feel to what you're actually doing when you're on the track, and then that'll give you a better idea on how to set it up.